Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm bringing you part 5 of What If Goku Is My Hero Academia. In the last part, Goku and Ko went to Ai Island and gained a new ally in the form of Broly after an intense battle with him and the feature between Goku and Nezuko. So, without further ado, let's begin. At the League of Villains HQ, a small old man enters the building. The villains look at him and some laugh at his frail figure.
Who are you? Get out!
Not so fast, Shigaraki. I'm actually here to join your little group.
And what abilities do you possess that we can use?
You said it yourself, dear friend. Possession. Possession is one of my many capabilities. You see, my quirk is known as black magic. My name is Babidee, and I can grant power to anyone as long as they submit to my rule. Really? How interesting. Vegeta. Vegeta. The boy with the Saiyan quirk. Yes, yes, yes. I can make you stronger than anything that you can imagine. I can make you a Super Saiyan.
Meanwhile, back at UA, Broly is currently in the UA's hospital and is getting checked up on after Roof Ram stabbed him in the chest with a quirk amplifier. There's now a few scars on him and inside of his body is a melted piece of the power amplifier, which cannot be surgically removed and will give Broly the kind of potential that he hasn't can. Right now, he seems in control, but is undecided if he'll be a loose cannon or not. For now, he's under the watch of UA. Time passes and the summer camp arc begins. Goku, at this point, has been trained to use Super Saiyan like it's his base. Goku joins everyone at the pool, and everyone seems to enjoy themselves. Later, they have a pool racing contest, and here, Goku manages to outspeed Todoroki with the use of Super Saiyan. The final match is Goku, Deku, and Bakugo, and they prepare themselves for the race. And then suddenly, Goku reverts to base, Deku powers down from One For All, and Bakugo's explosions don't activate, as Aizawa erased their quirks and scolded them for using them without permission. Later, they all get into their uniforms as they enter the bus to go to the training camp. Goku and Momo find themselves sitting next to each other during the whole bus ride, and both since the events of Season 2 and two heroes have grown very far closer. Momo laughs at all Goku's cheesy jokes, and she then asks Goku how he's feeling now about his parents. And Goku says he's much better and isn't sad anymore. He just has to kick the villain's asses harder. Momo laughs at that comment.
You know, I do really admire how you can always manage to make yourself and others smile in the most dreadful situations.
Momo, after saying that, stares at Goku with a cute smile. Goku for the first time blushes and he averts his eyes. He scratches his head and thanks her bashfully. Momo giggles and again notices that Goku has a staff. She smiles and then decides to lean on him, knowing how important that staff means to him when it was given from her. Class A sees the moment that they're sharing together, and they all share a knowing glance towards each other. Goku and Momo have just realized how silent the boss has gotten and look up to see everyone staring at them. Their faces immediately become red as a tomato after being spotted, being so close to each other. They try to explain how it's just a misunderstanding and everyone just laughs at their expense. They arrive at the forest and meet the Wild Wild Pussycats. They begin their test to try and escape the forest and things remain relatively the same. Not much else really happens until the quirk training session. Here, Goku is tasked with trying to evolve a Super Saiyan form. Goku meditates for a while as everyone trains, eventually stands up.
Alright, here goes.
Goku then begins to power up into a Super Saiyan. He continues to power up further. His muscles begin to grow in size as his hair also grows, and his power increases 62 times that one in his form.
Wow, that power's amazing!
I can go one step further if I wanted to.
Goku continues to power up. His clothing begins to tear apart as his muscle mass continues to increase. His veins begin to bulge from him as he tries to maintain this new power, which is now 75 times stronger than his base. But only mere seconds after achieving his third grade of Super Saiyan, he's sent back to base and is about to faint. He's quickly caught by Momo, who sets him down and gives him some water to drink.
Thanks.
It's really no problem. Are you okay? It looked like you were seconds away from bursting a vein.
Yeah, I'm fine. Don't worry.
Well, that's a relief. Also, don't use that again. That transformation is useless.
Huh? How would it? He looks so strong like that.
Momo's right. That transformation may be extremely powerful, but it consumes way too much energy to use. Plus, those big bulky muscles will only be a hindrance to my speed. Strength means nothing in the fight if you can't hit your opponent.
Huh. I guess I understand where you're coming from. When I harden my body, it makes it difficult to move around too.
Well, I guess I should try and find a power beyond Super Saiyan that keeps me slim. For now, I'm just gonna try and stay in Super Saiyan for as long as possible. I'll power down once it stops feeling weird.
10 passes and Goku does exactly what he said he was gonna do. And once his stamina is back, he remains in Super Saiyan for 24 hours. Minata isn't there, so no one tries to peek on the guards, thankfully. And later, the villains attack. Goku does his best to protect his teammates, and Goku helps Deku defeat Muscular, and picks both Deku and Kota up, and flies them to safety. Goku, now knowing that the villains are after Bakugo, immediately dashes towards Bakugo to help him. Mr. Compress arrives, and Goku jumps in the way of an attack aimed for Bakugo, and gets sealed inside of an orb. This, shockingly, was their plan all along. They take Goku and retreat.
Goku! No! Get back here, you bastards!
We cut to the villain's hideout, and once again, Goku wakes up. He's tied up and surrounded by villains.
Let me go, or you'll regret it. All Might's gonna shut up, brat, or else we'll just kill you right now. You don't have a chance, and you know it.
Goku then breaks free and turns into a Super Saiyan. He then goes to attack, but he phases right through a portal and is back on the seat. But this energy burst was all that the heroes needed to track his coordinates. All Might then bursts through the ceiling, and Goku escapes, but then gets surrounded by villains once again. Deku, Ida, Kirishima, and Momo all work together to save Goku from the villains. Goku flies up to them, but as he goes to grab Momo's hand, he's suddenly punched flying back into the ground. Goku holds his busted nose as blood drips from him. He looks up to see a familiar figure landing down.
It's you. Long time no see, Goku. Our reunion has been overdue.
Goku explodes into Super Saiyan 1.
Get a new tattoo. Suit your receding hairline. Watch your tongue. You have no idea how powerful I become. You're not the only one who can go Super Saiyan now.
Huh?
Just watch. Here you will breathe your last.
Vegeta then powers up and his aura explodes in the golden light. His heart turns gold and his eyes go into a greenish blue. Goku is left in shock.
Well, looks like this won't be as quick as I thought it would. Precisely.
A helicopter flies by. Both All Might and All For One are recorded, along with Goku and Vegeta.
Looks like we have an audience. Damn it. What's wrong? Don't heroes like being famous? Or is it the fact the whole world knows exactly who you are now? Bardock and Gine's born.
Goku punches Vegeta flying through a wall.
Keep my parents' names out of your mouth, lonely trash. You've got a spy now. Good.
Vegeta then bursts his aura and then rushes towards Goku. Goku does the same as they clash fists, causing a massive explosion. Their fight begins and Vegeta prevents Goku from helping All Might, so Goku has to take this battle elsewhere with him as he doesn't want to distract All Might from his fight.
All Might, do your best and kick that bastard's ass.
All Might nods and Goku then punches Vegeta flying into the sky. A helicopter follows the two as they fight. Vegeta then punches Goku in the stomach and Goku retaliates with an elbow to the head. Goku and Vegeta seem to be on par with each other. Each punch causes a shockwave. Vegeta kicks Goku into the stomach and Goku grabs his leg and spins around before throwing him. He continues to dash towards Vegeta and Vegeta then punches him in the chin and then sends him flying across the city. Vegeta shoots several energy blasts and Goku counters with his own. Explosions obscure Goku's vision as Vegeta then appears behind Goku and hammers him into a building. Goku crashes into the ground as he stands up and immediately dashes towards the crumbling building. And changes all of his strength into speed to grab everyone and escape before they get crushed. He manages to save them, but Vegeta immediately grabs Goku's face and grinds him across the ground. Goku wraps his legs around Vegeta's arm and then tackles him. Goku then dashes back and then tries to escape the city, but Vegeta grabs his leg and slams him to the ground once again, cracking a rib and knocking the aura of him entirely, and almost reverting Goku back to base. Goku forces himself back into Super Saiyan and uppercuts Vegeta, trying to get him into the aura again, but Vegeta immediately kicks Goku into the face and saps on his chest.
What's wrong? You seem distracted. Don't tell me you're worried about these weaklings. Don't worry. After I kill you, I'll happily destroy everything you ever cared about. I'm a nice guy like that.
Goku, enraged, hits Vegeta with an Aryu Blast to the face. Goku continues to punch him repeatedly before finally kicking him into the air and hitting him with a Kamehameha. Vegeta explodes out of it, but Goku then dashes behind him and slams his fist into the back of Vegeta's head, knocking him out. The mark on Vegeta's head suddenly dissolves as he reverts the base. Vegeta, a couple of seconds later, wakes up. He's too injured to move. He weakly looks up to see Goku's stern face looking down on him.
Get on with it. Kill me.
Before Goku can say anything, he senses danger. Goku kicks Vegeta out of the way as a beam grazes Goku's cheek. He turns around to see a man who looks almost like a lizard. He has a tail, his skin is white and purple. His eyes are red and he has black lips. An evil, intimidating aura surrounds him as he speaks.
Oh my. I never expected you to save that failure. I'll finish what he started and end both your lives quickly, monkeys.
And that's where I'm going to leave this part off for now. What do you think of this part? And what do you think will happen to the next? Comment your suggestions below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. And also don't forget to follow I'm Eat Your Kids on TikTok. She voiced Momo in this video and also drew some more amazing artwork for this video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Peace out, guys.